Epic Games is most known for our video games like Fortnite and Rocket League, but that's really only part of the story. The other half of Epic is really about empowering creation, and we do that in a bunch of ways. The first way is with the Unreal Engine. And the Unreal Engine is a suite of creation tools that are used to create some really amazing interactive experiences. Since all the lockdowns began and all the stay-at-home orders began, we saw a tremendous increase in the number of people who were using Fortnite and Rocket League as an outlet, not just as an escape, but also as a way to stay in touch with their friends and family. For example, it's much more than just a game where you're trying to get a victory royale. It really is a place for people to connect socially with their friends and family. You know, beyond just that growth from a, you know, day-to-day technical point of view, we made sure that we handled that load. We also wanted to make sure that we provided new experiences that let people connect socially. So we created a series of events on what we call Party Island. And that ranged from things like concerts with Diplo and BTS and Anderson .Paak and others to new video premieres and other events, just to try to give people a way to kind of escape from their real world into a virtual world for a little while and to forget about 2020. Sure, we rely heavily on AWS to help us manage that scale. These events require a tremendous amount of scale. They require us to be running servers around the world. And, you know, I think we're in a couple of dozen data centers and AWS regions around the world today. And AWS really helps us to scale up and down and to manage that growth in a way that keeps our teams from having to worry about infrastructure in a kind of direct day-to-day way, and to really focus on delivering experiences to our customers. Yeah, scaling for us is a constant thing. At Fortnite scale, the number of users who are playing at any given time of day changes dramatically between off-peak and on-peak. We can see, you know, 10, 20, 30x more players at peak times than we see in the middle of the night, for instance. And we rely very heavily on the elasticity we get with EC2 to allow us to scale up and down to meet that demand in a natural way. So that's a normal part of our business. Optimizing for infrastructure costs when you're at our scale is something we do all the time, from things like making aggressive use of auto-scaling everywhere we can, to building a custom auto-scaling engine of our own that really follows player demand as closely as possible so that we scale up and down just in time, to doing reviews of our architecture and infrastructure to make sure that we're using our services appropriately, and, you know, to looking at things like savings plan and reserved instances to really make the most out of every dollar that we spend on infrastructure. The most exciting thing for us all at Epic is this idea of the metaverse. And Tim Sweeney's talked about this a lot. Really, we see in the future kind of all entertainment experiences moving online over time. And we think that the foundational technologies that we've built with Unreal Engine and Epic Online Services, and this taste that we get in Fortnite with our live events, just gives you a little bit of a glimpse of what that might be like in the future. And that's really exciting to us. And that's kind of what we're all driving towards.